patient-reported outcome is a measure of patient health functions, physical functions, mental function, productivity, or anything from patient's perspective above and beyond the typical efficacy measures in healthcare. People always cares about quality of life. You go to a doctor and the doctor will say, how you doing, right? They cares about how the patient feel. But as a science, as the rigorous measurement to understand how does patient feel, this is really coming from around the 70s. So over the past 4-5 decades, it has really evolved and become a very important healthcare discipline.
Patient-reported outcome instrument is a set of questions that has been validated and scientifically get the input from patients and the clinicians. It can be used in clinical trials or in clinical practice to understand the burden of a disease or the benefit of a treatment from a patient perspective. The data, the information we can capture using the set of questions essentially can be quantified and can be analyzed to support if a patient has certain burden about the disease, as well as if there is a benefit gained because of a treatment. Regulatory agencies, they are the one really look into the drug efficacy and say if the drug works and should be approved for the treatment.
Nowadays, sometimes you get a drug and the pill and on the box, there's a label. And some of the drug, you will see it improve patient's quality of life. This reduce fatigue, this improve patient's quality of life, this improve patient function. So that is actually one of the efficacy measure. Any product that's going into the marketplace, most of the time, there is a question of will insurance cover it. So FDA, EMA, these regulatory agencies will take quality of life evidence as part of the drug approval evidence, and the insurance health technology assessment agency will use it to decide the pricing and the target population. So in this kind of assessment, an important question is, what is the value of drug? And if you think about what's the value of drug, it could extend life, it could make patient have a better life. So both of these are important.
In the clinical trial setting, the pharma companies, when design a trial, really want to include as much or as many patient-reported outcome instruments as possible.
Traditional PRO has been very helpful in measure patients' quality of life and outcomes. However, this suffers from some limitations. Many of these are bulky, long questionnaires that is not well used in clinical practice because it takes too long, and some of these are not flexible or they have floor and ceiling effect. In recent years, there has been a lot of significant development in PRO measure, what I call the next generation of PRO measures. They become much shorter, flexible, and dealt with the floor effect and ceiling effect so much better, and many of these can also be disease specific. At analysis group, we have been a wide range of patient-reported outcome research. It's really the full range, anywhere from analyzing clinical trial data, which traditionally covers quality of life or patient-reported outcomes, understand the patient disease burden, including productivity loss and quality of life burden, and also developing new instruments, often working together with AG affiliates and experts to develop a new instrument and new utility measures in different disease areas.
Analysis group is also working with the Patient-Centered Outcome Research Institute, for short, PCORI. We are working on a PRO initiative that will incorporate the use of PRO data.
PCORI is the electronic medical record system developed across the U.S. There are 13 PCORI centers, and each center will connect the patient EHR data in the whole region. Never in the history we have so much of patient medical data being connected in such a comprehensive way to support research and advanced medicine. For example, patients often stay in the waiting room for 5 to 10 minutes, and now it allows them to use a handheld tablet and spend 2 minutes and be able to enter their patient quality of life or patient reported outcome measures. So we think this will exemplify the future trend of PRO research.